For me, when I come to the party and I set up my altar and I sprinkle the Ganga water and say the mantra and make the offering to the cosmic spirit, the whole party becomes the offering. The music becomes the offering. The dance becomes the offering. Cosmic spirit should come to the place and bless all of us. The longer it goes on, the more the trance comes. And it comes to a point where every song is so perfect in the moment, it's timelessness. So perfect you start to get chills up your spinal column and out the outside of your skin, and everybody's getting that all at once. It's like a cosmic orgasm. Then at some point it comes like a shock of lightning, like a bolt of lightning through everyone all at once. And that's when the seed is being planted in everyone's subconscious that will hopefully grow and flower and make people more sensitive and aware of themselves, their surroundings, the crossroads of humanity, and the needs of the planet. This is what our Goa party, our holy ritual is all about. And this is what we are trying to achieve with it.
So, you take, let us assume, a third toke, long and slow. You vaporize, and you take it in and in and in, and there is a sound like the crumpling of a plastic bread wrapper or the crackling of flame, and a tone, and there is this. A cheer. The gnomes have learned a new way to say who.
One way or another. If you're going to be a yogi, be a yogi. If you want to take drugs, that's what you're going to do. If you want to be straight, that's what you're going to be. The main thing is, the whole game is to alter your consciousness, to get higher, to go to those other dimensions, to fulfill our potential. And one of the ways we can do this is through music, because it's healing and elevating, and it will take people to a higher realm of consciousness if they let it.
Sensational fluctuation of the mind. from what I've seen of this pure paper, the whiteness of this paper, you have to remove all these lines, isn't it? Similarly, the mind, too, covers the real consciousness, the real thing which you are. So you have to remove all this darkness, all these lines and taintedness, which is the mind. Then you, the natural beauty of the base, the foundation, is automatically observed, isn't it? It is natural, it is always there. Does a dead man see his mind? So he must be conscious. You are nature. Aren't you nature? So if you hurt any part of nature, it will certainly rebound back on you.
Radios have an FM frequency.
You can tune in this information just like turning the radio on.
Like a radio station, that little twist on a dial makes all the difference.
It's on all the time.
The frequency is broadcast and then the music is modulated along this frequency. Now you can
allow yourself the stillness, which meditation of course has allowed me. That is how I feel I've tuned into this information. And I am sure that anyone who wanted to take the time to investigate their own inner realms, they would find extraordinary information there.
Certainly as a metaphor, you can see music as a form of carrier wave that modulates spiritual intent.
No matter how you can conceive our universe, however large it is, however infinitely expanding it is, there is these possibilities now of alternative universes, one billionth of a quark away from us. And if we can tune into that, we get into those other dimensions. Now, there's a long way of saying, do these dimensions exist? Of course they exist, and we all experience them. How do we experience them? We experience them, for instance, by coincidence. Right, so something really weird happened. I'm sure it happened to you last week. A really weird coincidence. You think, wow, man, that couldn't have... But that's not coincidence. That is an actual divine manifestation of the groovology policy that is happening in alternative realities. And everybody is for us, as we were saying before. We have these guardian spirits, we have these guardian planets, we have giants that are overlooking us. They may be 2,000 miles tall, and they are our spirits that help us and protect us through all the universes.
If you strike a key, or a string, it's a better example, a string, just a chord, a monophonal.
You've got to be a scientist of sound.
Every other tone that's possible is happening within that tone.
I find it is more likely to produce spiritual energy along that metaphor.
And from that octave, the fifths will ring, and from the fifths, the fours, and so on and so on. 12 times, that's the cycle of fifths, 12 times, and it will repeat to the same sound again. And but this same sound is a quarter note off, but that's a total other story.
I mean, look at Albert Hofmann. When he got up to LSD 24, nothing worked. And then years later, he went back and he brought out that thing. He worked on it until he found LSD 25. And then the magic of shamanism came together through science and theology. And at that moment, something transcendental happened to the consciousness of the planet.
This poster, Fortune Eric Technicolor Dream, was the first psychedelic event that I ever went to in this country. I went on the first weekend I came out of hospital after breaking my back to see if I could adjust to the outside world, and I certainly, it was definitely, the world was ready for me with this happening. And the person who put this on, who organized it, Hoppy, also was responsible for sending me to my first TIP party, which was my first Goa trance style party. Music heightens our spirits, it brings people together in a coordinated body movement and coordinated mindset as well. People are in similar mental states, even people without drugs get into those mental states. And through the dance and the repetitive movement, which is credited by leading anthropologists as being the original basic driver of all social organizations and all social forms, originated with or synchronized body movement. And it's something that's been, you know, dreadfully lost in society. And music keeps that going. And trance music raises it to new heights. This is how it is. It's a church of personal revelations. And people share their revelations. Sometimes you wake up in the morning and it was crap, but sometimes you wake up in the morning and you're enriched for the rest of your life by a perception you've had about, could be yourself, or it could be how people interact. You might have discovered food. I mean, for me, when I first, when I first took acid, it does enable people to break out of ruts that they've been in. This is what I've always eaten, this is what I've always listened to, this is all my mates always were. People can't get out of those ruts. You take psychedelic, you can. You get far enough out of your current state of existence that you can see, you can experiment with other things, be open to them, and see the error of your ways sometimes and the brilliance of your future. Well, enjoy it and be grateful to it. I think that's a very important part, is to send some actual gratitude and thanks back to whatever it is that has enabled us to have this paradise here.
It only came together in Goa for a lot of that music. It only made sense in Goa, but it was made by people from different places.
When I went there,
from around the world, basically. And I went to a few parties, and I was like amazed. And then I became really inspired by it. I realised this world really was the future of music in a lot of ways. It was all about the spirit and the feel of music. It becomes a language through which you can find your own identity. I think Goa is a particularly fertile place for it to begin and nurture it, for it to gather its strength.
Maybe it was an uncle, it was planted and it was a seed in Goa, and then it flowered and spread everywhere.
That has been a long, well-trodden route of a long, very old tree, which goes back millennia and involves the very basic elements of humanity, which is dancing under a million stars. I found I could draw correspondences with Brahmin priests and the Druids and Rajasthani fiddle players and the Irish fiddle players. And there were a lot of correspondences in fact. And I think there are all native cultures. To have them reawakened in yourself and then reinterpreted by yourself and integrated into your contemporary world is the way forward for society. And we have to rediscover those truths of our ancestors in our own way.
And we can do this through the parties and through our dance, and that's why this is a really important thing we're involved in right now. It's not frivolous. It's not